When we think about our health, we tend to focus on major internal organs, but our eyes may also experience some dangerous conditions, accidents, or diseases. Let's take a look, if you dare. Number 10, eye injuries caused by popping bottles. You don't have to open a bottle with your eye to end up with a serious injury on your cornea, but rather keep your face too close when popping a cold one open. An Alabama study revealed that glass splinters from broken glass bottles account for 1% of serious eye injuries. Researchers analyzed patients that ended up with trauma after opening bottles, and they concluded that glass is responsible for the most severe cases, which involved open globe trauma caused by splinters. These tiny fragments of glass are easy to miss, and the blinking reflex is useless in these situations. 26% of the patients involved in the study remained legally blind. In addition to the splinters, bottle tops can cause serious trauma too. The champagne cork was found to be the main culprit for severe eye injuries. Many people end up in the emergency room after opening the celebratory bottle. Blinking won't help because it takes the cork 0.05 seconds to reach the eye, which isn't enough time for the eyelids to close. Number 9, globe luxation. Spontaneous or traumatic globe luxation, commonly known as floppy eye, is a rare condition which manifests when the globe is displaced and the eyelids retract behind it, tethering the optic nerve. It can be caused by thyroid eye disease, floppy eye syndrome, a shallow orbit, or even trauma like having the eye poked out of its socket or knocked out, and it can even occur when experiencing blunt trauma like a car accident. The condition can cause pain and severe anxiety. However, it's highly treatable. In some lucky cases, it can be managed with simple maneuvers like looking down while the doctor is pinching the upper lid, simply pushing the eye back into its socket. However, more severe cases require surgical treatment, which can increase the risk of luxation in the future. Number 8, eye paralysis. Ophthalmoplegia, or eye paralysis, is a common condition that usually occurs as a symptom of diseases such as diabetes, peripheral artery disease, or even cardiovascular problems. It can affect one or more of the six muscles that hold the eye in place. Symptoms include difficulty in controlling the movements of the eye, droopy eyelids, blurred or double vision, inability to position the eyes in sync, migraines, strokes, brain injury, brain tumors, infections, or thyroid disease are common causes of eye paralysis. However, it's more likely to occur in people suffering from diabetes, especially men over the age of 45 who have had type 2 diabetes for more than 10 years. Treatment depends on the type, symptoms, and underlying cause. Sometimes the condition can be controlled with special glasses, and some doctors recommend wearing an eye patch in order to relieve double vision. Number 7, eye tumors. Eye tumors usually appear inside of your ocular globe and are most often caused by cancers that are spread from other parts of the body such as lung, breast, prostate, or bowel. However, some tumors, called limbal dermoids, will appear on the surface of the eye and will grow tissues like muscle, skin, fat, neurological tissue, cartilage, hair follicles, and even sweat or lacrimal glands. They're benign but may affect vision because either the tumor is blocking visual input from entering the eye, or it's causing the cornea to have an irregular shape. The majority of limbal dermoids occur in teenagers up to 16. Although doctors usually recommend spectacle correction for the smaller lesions, or even no treatment in cases when they don't impair vision. These tumors can be surgically removed. However, they can cause post-operative scarring or pseudopterygium, the advancement of the conjunctiva on the corneal surface. Number 6. Crying blood. Hemlocrea is a condition characterized by crying tears that are partially composed of blood. In some cases, the tears may appear slightly red-tinged, while in others, the tears may look like they're entirely made of blood. Acute hemolacria can be induced by hormones in fertile women, but in most cases, it masks more serious diseases, although most often provoked by bacterial conjunctivitis, injuries, or environmental damage. It can also be indicative of a tumor in the lacrimal apparatus. Although some of the causes are known, in many cases, hemolacria remains a mystery for both doctors and the sufferers alike, despite the fact it's a fairly rare disease. Several cases have been reported in Tennessee. Even stranger, hemolacria may end as unexpectedly as it started, even after years of manifesting in a patient. Number 5. Bacterial keratitis. Bacterial keratitis is an infection of the cornea, which can result in vision loss or blindness if left untreated, because it can completely destroy the cornea within 24 hours. It usually occurs in people who wear contact lenses, but may also affect those who don't wear them. Symptoms include eye redness, blurred vision, excessive tearing, sensitivity to light, and even eye discharge. It's caused by a bacteria commonly found in nature and on the human body, and usually lives on human skin or on the protective lining inside the body called the mucous membrane, and can't be spread from person to person. In nature, it's found in water or soil. Treatment generally requires urgent antibacterial, antifungal, or antiviral therapy. In addition, doctors strongly recommend taking a break from wearing contact lenses to patients who usually wear them. Those who sleep in their contacts are 10 to 15 times more likely to contract the bacteria and develop the infection. Number 4. Globe rupture. A globe rupture may happen after a blunt or penetrating trauma, or may result from damage caused by different substances such as strong acids or industrial chemicals. It occurs when the outer membranes of the eye are completely or partially compromised. The eye appears to deflate as the vitreous and/or the aqueous humor drain through the site of the rupture. Globe ruptures require immediate ophthalmologic intervention and may often result in permanent loss of vision, which is why prompt recognition and treatment are essential to avoid this outcome. In more severe cases, or when the injury is not treated swiftly, the affected eye may be completely destroyed. This means the only treatment is inoculating the affected eye socket and replacing the eye with an ocular prosthesis. Number 3. Ocular herpes. Just like regular herpes, ocular herpes is a common viral recurrent infection that can cause inflammation and painful bumps on the skin surface, in this case, on the eyelid. In most severe cases, the herpes might flare up inside of the eye, causing temporary vision loss. Other symptoms include photophobia and headaches, which occur before the swelling and the redness. Sometimes, this type of herpes virus can cause scarring of the cornea, commonly referred to as a cold sore on the eye. When affecting the top layer of the cornea, the infection usually heals without scarring. However, there's a severe type of ocular herpes called stromal keratitis, which occurs when the infection goes deeper into the layers of the cornea. In most cases, it only causes temporary loss of vision, but can eventually lead to blindness. Although it's a rare condition, it's classified as the leading cause of corneal scarring, leading to blindness in the United States. The virus can be contracted during close contact with an infected person whose virus is active at the same time of the interaction. Number 2. Lower filariasis. Lower filariasis is a skin and eye disease caused by the lower worm, also known as the African eye worm. Symptoms can include caliber swellings, red itchy swellings under the skin, urticaria, pruritus. Adult worms can migrate to the eyes and damage the retina or the peripheral nervous system. Once they've crossed into the subconjunctival tissues of the eye, they can be seen floating inside the iris. Usually, the lower worm doesn't affect your vision. However, movements of the eye may become painful painful during the infestation. Other symptoms that may occur if the worm hasn't migrated to the eye may include arthritis, colonic lesion, or kidney disease. Lower worms are transmitted to humans through mango or deer fly bites. They're most commonly found in rainforest-like environments in Central and West Africa. Treatment of lower filariasis may involve chemotherapy, or in case the infection is visible and can be precisely localized, surgical removal of adult worms. Number 1. River blindness. River blindness, or onchocerciasis, is the second most common cause of blindness due to infection. It's a disease caused by infestation with the parasitic worm Onchocerca volvulus. Similar to the Luwalua, the worm is transmitted to humans by the bites of a black fly, a species that lives near rivers, hence the name of the disease. Most infections occur in sub-Saharan Africa, with some cases also being reported in Yemen and isolated areas of South and Central America. Signs you've been infested may include scattered pruritic papules, hyperpigmentation, pruritus, loss of elasticity of the skin, and finally, strange visions. If the eye has been infected, one may start seeing shadows, or worse, nothing. Approximately 15.5 million people are infected with river blindness, and almost 1 million have suffered some amount of vision loss from the infection. River blindness is listed by the World Health Organization as a neglected tropical disease. There's no vaccine against it, and the only way of prevention is avoiding being bitten by flies and using insect repellent and proper clothing. However, there are ongoing efforts to eradicate the disease by treating entire groups of people twice a year. In 2005, a Crip who joined the US Army was assigned to the Finance Battalion and was later found guilty of being involved in drug distribution while still serving. In 2006, 18 members of the Crips, four of whom were US Marines, were arrested for planning to attack